With me.
Goku and Piccolo, the Earth's two greatest fighters, confront the Saiyan invader Raditz. Though his son is still locked away in the Saiyan space pod, Goku refuses to submit to Raditz's demands. He vows to defeat Raditz and save the Earth, or die trying.
I'll teach you a lesson, fool.
We'll see about that!
You can block enemy ki attacks with your own ki attacks.
Desperate to help his father, young Gohan's anger explodes, and the incredible powers sleeping within him are momentarily awakened. Gohan attacks, then lands a critical blow to weaken the evil Raditz. Goku summons the last of his strength, and in a valiant effort, sacrifices his own life to ensure the villain's defeat and save the human race from utter destruction. The battle won. Piccolo is confident that Goku's friends will use the power of the Dragon Balls to wish the fallen hero back to life. But with his final words, Raditz dashes Piccolo's hopes by informing him that two even more powerful Saiyans are on their way to Earth. In 1 year, they will arrive, and they will stop at nothing to have the Dragon Balls for their own evil purposes.
Out of my way!
Led by Piccolo and Gohan, the Z Warriors join forces to combat the Saiyan threat. But despite their best efforts, none are able to stand up to the power of the Saiyans. One by one, the Z-Warriors fall, until only Piccolo and Gohan are left as the Earth's last line of defense against the evil Vegeta and Nappa.
I'll crush you!
You're gonna have to do better than that!
Fight off Nappa until Goku can get back to Earth!
Next dimension!
Have you had enough yet?
Yeah.
fight takes a deadly turn. Piccolo dives in front of Nappa's attack, giving his own life to save Gohan. As Gohan bids a final farewell to his friend and mentor, his father Goku returns from Otherworld and races to the battlefield to put an end to the carnage once and for all. Saiyan's Duel. Wished back to life by the power of the Dragon Balls, Goku arrives on the battlefield determined to stop the Saiyans. And after making quick work of Nappa with his new Kaioken attack, it appears our hero will do just that. But when Vegeta steps into the fight, nothing is certain. Disgusted by Nappa's poor performance, he obliterates his now useless henchman in a ferocious display of power. Now, free of distraction, he has set his evil eye on Goku. Can Goku stand up to the might of the ruthless Saiyan Prince?
You are no match for a super elite.
You'll regret that.
Gallagher!
bodies battered and broken. The battle between Goku and Vegeta ends in a draw. Vegeta has no choice but to flee the Earth, but vows one day to return and finish the fight. In the battle's aftermath, the remaining Z fighters search for a way to bring their fallen friends back to life. When Piccolo's life faded from this world, the Earth's Dragon Balls also faded from existence. But a second set of Dragon Balls may still remain on Kami and Piccolo's original homeworld, the planet Namek. Clinging to hope, Krillin, Gohan, and Bulma embark on a quest across the galaxy to find the Namekian Dragon Balls. Back on Earth, Goku recovers from his wounds and immediately races to help his friends on planet Namek. Meanwhile, Vegeta and the Z team have succeeded in bringing the seven magic Dragon Balls together, but their plans to summon the Namekian Dragon Purunga are cut short by the arrival of the Ginyu Force. The battle begins as Goldo, the weakest member of the Ginyu Force, steps into the fray. Through their combined efforts, Krillin, Gohan, and Vegeta manage to win the first bout, but the fight is far from over. An even more powerful Ginyu is waiting to take Goldo's place. Raccoon.
Yeah. You're playing with the big boys now.
Shut up!
Oh, my God.
fighting is fierce as Gohan, Krillin, and Vegeta struggle against the enormous Raccoon. But in the end, none can stand against the Ginyu's ferocious power. Defeat seems certain for our heroes as Raccoon prepares to launch his finishing blow when a new hope suddenly arrives. Goku storms the battlefield and displays the strength he gained during his training at 100 times gravity by defeating Raccoon in an instant. Then, with his bag of Senzu beans in tow, he sets about helping his fallen friend.
This is a waste of...
Captain Ginyu. Goku and Vegeta square off against the remaining Ginyu fighters. Do the Saiyan warriors stand a chance against the power of Berter and Jace?
Give it up, mate!
Nobody can stop the Ginyu Force!
Bring it on!
We'll see about that!
You can only carry 3 Senzu beans at a time. You can only carry 3 Senzu beans at a time.
Whoa, that was close!
You're no match for us.
Bring it on!
Vegeta and Goku launch an overwhelming attack, and Berter crumbles before their combined force. But before Jace can suffer a similar fate, he makes a hasty retreat from the battlefield. With the Ginyu threat momentarily averted, the Z Warriors resume their quest for the Dragon Ball. As the Z Warriors clash against Frieza's army of evil henchmen, Jace returns with reinforcements. The leader and most powerful member of the Ginyu Force himself, Captain Ginyu. In order to defeat this deadly foe, the Z Warriors will have to fight for their lives.
Give me all you've got!
Captain Ginyu's defeat seemingly assured, Vegeta takes off in search of the Dragon Balls. But the wily captain still has a trump card up his sleeve. In a wild move, Captain Ginyu inflicts a horrific wound upon himself, then uses his secret technique to switch bodies with Goku. After the successful switch, Captain Ginyu and Jinx fly back to Frieza's ship to check on the Dragon Balls, leaving Goku for dead. Goku isn't Goku. Vegeta arrives at Frieza's ship just in time to see Krillin and Gohan uncover the hidden Dragon Balls. At that same moment, Jace and Captain Ginyu return. In his newly acquired body, Captain Ginyu attempts to convince the Z Warriors that he is Goku. But it doesn't take Gohan long to realize that things are not what they seem.
Let's see what this body can really do. Now feel the power of the Ginyu Force!
Nonsense! I will crush you!
Thank you.
feel my true power!
Oh, you got lucky on that one!
Vegeta destroys Jace and launches a powerful assault against Captain Ginyu, giving Goku the chance he needs to undo the body switch. Now desperate, Captain Ginyu attempts to use his body switching technique against Vegeta. But thanks to Goku's quick thinking, the once fearsome captain finds himself somewhat reduced in stature. Gohan uses the Namekian Dragon Balls to wish Piccolo back to life. And with the return of Piccolo, the Earth's Dragon Balls also reappear. With Goku still recuperating from the battle with Captain Ginyu, Vegeta seizes the opportunity to make his own wish for immortality. But just as he prepares to voice his wish, on the other side of the planet, Elder Guru's life expires under the strain of Frieza's torment. With his passing, the Namekian Dragon Balls turn to stone. Badly injured and filled with grief over his beloved master's demise, Nail is determined to have the last laugh. He informs Frieza that without Guru, the quest for the Dragon Balls is over. Furious, Frieza races back to his ship to find the Dragon Balls ruined and his dreams of immortality shattered. Frieza vows revenge and turns the full force of his wrath on the one most responsible for his failure, Vegeta.
I won't let you win!
You must hold off Frieza until Piccolo arrives!
You fool! You'll never defeat me!
On the planet Namek, Piccolo uses the Namekian fusion technique to merge with the injured Nail. Their powers combined, incredible new strength surges through Piccolo's body as he races to join the battle against Frieza. Meanwhile, Vegeta has only begun to realize Frieza's destructive potential as the evil tyrant undergoes the first of three powerful transformations. Little does Vegeta know, the worst is yet to come.
I think it's time to finish this.
Makes a dramatic entrance onto the battlefield. His strength multiplied by the fusion with Nail, Piccolo seems to have the upper hand, at least until Frieza undergoes his second powerful transformation. The tide of battle quickly turns, and as Piccolo begins to falter, Gohan is forced to enter the fray. But even fighting with all his might, the young Saiyan proves to be only a minor annoyance to the evil Frieza as he transforms into his third and most powerful form. Super Saiyan Goku. His body finally healed, Goku returns to the battlefield in time to witness the horrific results of Frieza's murderous rampage. Dende and Vegeta have been killed. Piccolo lies near the brink of death. And when Krillin is destroyed right before his very eyes, Goku has seen enough. His rage explodes. And in a burst of power, he is transformed into a Super Saiyan. Faced with this new threat, Frieza launches an energy attack at the planet Namek itself. The blast penetrates the planet's core, triggering an unstoppable chain reaction that will ultimately cause the planet to explode. Meanwhile, back on Earth, Kami and Mr. Popo gather the Dragon Balls and use them to wish all of Frieza's victims back to life. Guru is revived, thus restoring the Namekian Dragon Balls to their original luster. The clock ticking. Dende quickly summons Purunga and wishes that everyone on the doomed planet Namek be transported to the safety of Earth. Everyone, that is, except Goku and Frieza. With his friends safely off the planet, Goku has chosen to stay behind, determined to put an end to Frieza's evil ways once and for all. But will his Super Saiyan strength be enough to stop the most powerful villain the universe has ever known?
I'll send you to the next dimension!
I won't let you get away with—
Use melee combat to increase your Super Saiyan potential!
Yeah. Gonzo Pete to the max and become a Super Saiyan!
It's useless! Give up!
Give me all you got!
To the next dimension!
Go ahead and try!
Frieza is defeated, but the victory comes at a high price as the planet Namek explodes in a fiery cloud. Back on Earth, fears run high that Goku did not escape the blast in time. The Z Warriors mourn the loss of their friend, but they vow to use the Dragon Balls to wish him back. Goku on Yardrat. A full year has passed, and the power of the Dragon Balls has been restored. Fulfilling their promise, the Z Warriors summon the dragon and wish Goku back to life. But they are shocked to learn that the dragon cannot grant this wish. Goku is still alive. Mere seconds before planet Namek exploded, Goku escaped in a Ginyu space pod, only to crash on a mysterious alien planet. For the last year, he has lived among the strange inhabitants of the planet Yardrat, studying and mastering their fighting techniques. And now, as he prepares to embark on the long and difficult journey home, he must put those skills to the test.
only carry 3 Senzu beams at a time.
Get you. weak.
Yeah.
all you got?
Suffers a near-fatal defeat by the androids, Trunks rushes his injured master back to his mother's underground home. Though his body is shattered and one of his arms lost, Bulma is slowly but surely able to nurse him back to health.
I'm going to get you.
I'm just getting started!
I'm done with you. Prepare to die.
Give me your best shot. Yeah! Is that all you've got?
Burning!
That's it. No more games.
I'm just getting started.
Yeah.
Useless, you have no chance.
I won't stop until you are destroyed!
Let me show you how it's done, 17.
Give me your best shot!
Focus your attacks on Android 18!
Did that hurt?
Give me your best shot!
Ah!
back to the past and help Goku.
This is the dark world Trunks left behind. And this is a future he now hopes to prevent. Super Saiyan Vegeta. The battle begins, and the androids are clearly unprepared for Goku in his Super Saiyan form. Goku's victory seems certain, until the mighty warrior suddenly begins clutching his heart in pain. Could this be the deadly heart virus of Trunks' warning? With Goku's advantage waning, Android 19 prepares to pounce when another Saiyan steps in to finish the fight. It's Vegeta, ready to show the world that he, too, has become a Super Saiyan.
The best is yet to come, Android.
You're nothing! I'll crush you!
Watching Vegeta send Android 19 to the scrap, Android 20, aka Dr. Gero, decides it is time to make a hasty retreat. Trunks arrives on the scene just in time to catch a glimpse and is shocked to discover that these androids are not the same ones that destroyed his future world. But there's no time to ponder this strange turn of events. The hunt for Dr. Gero is on. Dr. Gero escapes to his secret lab, one step ahead of the pursuing Z Warriors, and hastily activates two more of his diabolical creations, Android 17 and 18. But the doctor's haste proves to be his undoing. Refusing to submit to his control, the androids turn on their creator. The Z Warriors blast through the doors, just in time to witness the doctor's demise. And Trunks realizes that these new androids are the ones responsible for the destruction of his future world. Despite Trunks' best efforts to stop them, 17 and 18 manage to activate yet another android, number 16, a killing machine designed for the sole purpose of destroying Goku. Recognizing the threat, Trunks calls for a retreat, but Vegeta's pride will not let him back down. The Saiyan Prince launches into battle.
You don't even have a chance!
Focus your attacks on Android 18!
What was that?
I think it's time to finish this.
Having been easily defeated by the androids, the Z Warriors split up in search of new ways to increase their strength. Meanwhile, the androids set out in search of Goku. Should they find him, Goku will be unable to defend himself until the antidote can take effect and eliminate the heart virus that holds him in its deadly grip. The situation desperate, Piccolo travels to Kami's lookout in the hopes of fusing with the aged Namek. Long ago, Kami purged the evil from his heart, thus splitting himself into two equal halves, Kami and Piccolo. If these two halves were to become whole once again, the result would be a Namek of incredible power. Kami realizes that this fusion may be the only way to combat the android, but he is hesitant to agree, for he senses a new evil roaming the earth, a creature far more terrifying than the androids. Piccolo's fusion. After assessing the situation on Earth, Kami reluctantly agrees to fuse with Piccolo. In an explosion of power, the two halves are made whole again, and Piccolo is transformed into a Super Namek. The new and improved Piccolo races to Master Roshi's house, where the androids have gone in their hunt for Goku. Now Piccolo must put his powers to the test as he faces the androids alone.
Oh, it's you again. Don't you ever give up.
You'll be eating my fist.
Let's go.
17 rages on. The evil force Kami warned of rears its ugly head. Imperfect Cell. Cell's frustration grows as his search for Android 18 proves fruitless. He has traced the android to a chain of deserted islands, and he begins destroying the islands one by one in an attempt to flush her from hiding. But before he can close in on his target, Vegeta and Trunks arrive on the scene, eager to put their training in the hyperbolic time chamber to the test.
Fool! You don't even have a chance! Have a chance!
as the battle continues, Cell soon realizes he is outmatched by the father-son Super Saiyan duo. But in a crafty move, he temporarily blinds Trunks and Vegeta, then swoops down to absorb Android 18. His goal finally realized, the monster undergoes his final transformation and becomes Perfect Cell.
You can only carry 3 Senzu beams at a time.
Gun.
Vegeta resume the battle, but they are powerless to defeat Perfect Cell. Clearly amused by their efforts, Cell allows them to live. He challenges them, along with all of the Earth's most powerful fighters, to take part in a martial arts tournament. The Z Warriors have no choice but to agree. Now, they have just 1 week to train before the fate of the Earth is decided in the Cell Games. The Final Showdown. After witnessing the destruction of Android 16, Gohan's rage ignites, and in an explosion of raw power, he ascends to a new height of Super Saiyan strength. In this anger-fueled state, Gohan obliterates the army of Cell Jr., then sets his sights on their cruel master, Perfect Cell.
I will rule the universe.
You can't beat me!
Yeah.
bombards Cell with a series of punishing blows. His final punch so powerful that it causes the monster to spit out the absorbed Android 18. No longer complete, Cell's body returns to its previous state, and with the resulting loss of power, his defeat seems certain. Rather than be defeated by a child, Cell chooses to blow himself up, and the Earth along with him. With mere seconds left to act before the fiery explosion, Goku transports himself and Cell to King Kai's planet, once again sacrificing his life to save his friends. The battle with Cell is not yet over, however. A single cell of the monster's body survives the blast, from which he is able to regenerate, once again attaining his perfect form. Cell returns to Earth to finish the battle with Gohan, locked in the final showdown.
Gohan, you've got to use the Kamehameha to defeat Perfect Cell. I will rule the universe.
Catch me if you can! Kamehameha!
Prepare to meet your demise.
That's all you got?
You win.
You can't beat me!
Pathetic weaklings will never defeat me!
It's over! Give up! Kamehameha!
What's wrong with you?
Have you had enough yet?
His Kamehameha wave overwhelms Cell. When the smoke clears, Perfect Cell is no more, and a new era of peace on Earth has begun.